And here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Bayer after it aborted a large late-stage testing on a new anti-clotting drug due to lack of efficiency. This is a fresh blow to the drug maker after it was ordered to pay over $1 billion in a lawsuit involving its weed killer. Bayer shares tumbled to their lowest in 12 years on these news. The stock last traded down by over 17%. Also in focus, shares of Microsoft after it tapped ousted OpenAI CEO Sam Altman to head its advanced AI research team. Shares of Microsoft are up over 1% in pre-market trading. And we're also keeping a close watch on shares of Tesla after a U.S. judge dismissed an antitrust lawsuit accusing the car maker of monopolizing repairs and replacement parts. Tesla shares are up nearly 0.8% before the bell.
Asian markets ended Monday trade mostly higher. The Hong Kong Hang Seng led gains after Chinese regulators said they will support the financing activities of property developers. Chinese shares further got a boost after the People's Bank of China left its key rates unchanged. As for Japan, Nikkei 225, it briefly touched 33-year highs on strong earnings and offshore demand before running into profit-taking and closing 0.6% lower. Some notable stock movements in the region. Foxconn's electric car unit slumped in its market debut in Taiwan on concerns over headwinds in the highly competitive electric vehicle market. Foxtron shares fell 2.7% at the close, giving it a market capitalization of around $2.7 billion. Meanwhile, shares of Singtel shed 0.9% after the CEO of its Australian unit, Optus, quit. Kelly Bayer Rosmarin's resignation comes days after a network-wide outage left nearly half of Australia's 26 million people without phone or internet for 12 hours. Finally, shares of Tata Investment Corporation surged 14.5% ahead of the market debut of its engineering and product development unit this week. It will be the group's first IPO in nearly two decades. And here at home, the local bourse kicked off the trading week with losses, with the main index falling below the 6,200 level.
Critical support is at 6,000, and it actually has a good chance of holding, mainly because of the possibility that we have actually seen the peak of interest rates.
Okay.
Now, nevertheless, what we're shifting back now to data dependence because people are now asking how long will rates stay at these levels. Hopefully the 6,000 support level will hold, but it's actually due for some technical breather, if you will. Okay.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. bringing home some $672 million worth of investment pledges following his six-day trip to the U.S. Malacanang says American business leaders expressed interest in the country's telecommunications and healthcare sectors, among others. During his trip, Marcos pitched the country as a potential technological hub, but he also admitted upskilling the workforce needs to be done.
Dahil bata yung workforce natin, magaling tayo sa tech. Madali para sa atin ng technology. With the talent that we already have in the Philippines, konting upskilling na lang, and we will already be at the forefront of all of these technologies. We have made commitments for continued discussions so that we can put more detail into this.
President Marcos is expected to arrive later this evening.